Home Assistant 2022.10 is here and it is bringing some new stuff like iBeacons and Google Sheets support, as well as some updates of the dashboard, integrations, Bluetooth and more. Let's discuss! But before we start, I want to give you a useful and free PDF document that can help you along the way and that you can use to decode most of the smart home words and abbreviations that everybody is using. I call this PDF document a smart home glossary, and you can download it from my website automatelike.pro/glossary. And as I said, it is completely free. Now, let's start this video. The first new thing in Home Assistant 2022.10 that caught my attention are the subviews for dashboards. Subviews are created as usual. The only difference is that the subview switch have to be enabled. Then, inside the subview, I can add as many cards as I wish and I can order them the way I like, just like the regular view. But here comes the differences. The subviews are not shown in the navigation bar and they cannot be accessed the same way as the normal views. Instead, I have to link the subview to a button and to place that button on my main view. For example, I can make a living room button and I can link that button to the living room subview that I created. If I now click on the living room button, the living room subview will be opened. So from now on, I'll have a living room button that will lead me to all of my living room devices. If I click on the go back button, I'll see the main dashboard view again. Let me know in the comments, are you going to use that? Simple yes or no is enough. Next new thing that I want to talk about is the Google Sheets integration that is added in Home Assistant 2022.10. If you don't know, Google Sheets is the free cloud alternative of the Microsoft Excel. To use this integration, I have to go through a slightly complicated procedure described in the documentation and to link my Google account with Home Assistant by using the OAuth credentials. After that, I can call a new Home Assistant service that will log whatever info I want in a dedicated new Google Sheets document. The timestamp of the event will be automatically added in the Sheets document, and that way I can make my own logging system. At the moment, it is only possible to write in that Google Sheets document and I cannot read it from Home Assistant. But I guess this could be changed in the future. Next new integration that is introduced with Home Assistant 2022.10 is the iBeacon tracker integration. The iBeacons are battery-powered Bluetooth low-energy devices that have a working range of around 400 meters and they can last for over 5 years with one battery. You can attach these iBeacons to some random stuff at your home and then you can track them from your Home Assistant. Here, I'm not quite sure what will be the real use case of these devices and what exactly can be really useful to track using iBeacons. To me, the usefulness of such a device is close to zero. Nevertheless, I bought one. This iBeacon cost me around $20 and it is compatible with Home Assistant. The battery should last around 6 years and it is waterproofed. But I have no idea what I'm going to do with it. I hope to figure out something until I'm waiting it to arrive. Meanwhile, if you have some ideas for good application, share them in the comments. Next big thing that is coming with Home Assistant 2022.10 is active connections for Bluetooth remote proxies. It is already possible to use an ESP32 device as a Bluetooth proxy, and I'm showing everything about that in this video of mine. Until now, the drawback of this method was that only reading data from the connected Bluetooth devices was possible, and it was not possible to command them. Now, this should be fixed and both reading and executing actions against Bluetooth devices is possible. Of course, if the Bluetooth devices support that. In general, that completes the circle and allows using the ESP32 Bluetooth proxy method instead of buying Bluetooth dongles. Next, when you update to Home Assistant 2022.10, you'll be able to see in Visual Editor the manually added automations. These are the automations added as YAML code in the config folder of Home Assistant and more specifically in the automations.yaml file. It will not be possible to edit these manually added automations from the Visual Editor, but I'll be able to view them, and if I click on them, I can see what's inside the automation, I can look around, and if I want, I can migrate them by clicking on Migrate button. If I click OK here, my automation will be automatically migrated for me, and I can start editing as usual. This is a very nice new addition for anyone, including me, that is having some old and working good YAML-based automations, but it is too lazy, like me, to recreate them using the Visual Automation Editor. Going ahead, because the supported brands is now updated in Home Assistant 2022.10. The supported brands is a functionality introduced not so long ago, and it is basically a virtual link between connected brands. For example, when you try to add a device from a brand A, you can be automatically offered to use brand B integration. This is because the brand A and B are virtually connected and their products are compatible with each other. Now, in 2022.10, this functionality is further enhanced so that the Home Assistant can offer you multiple choices of integration. For example, if you are trying to add a device in Home Assistant that is Zigbee compatible, can work with HomeKit, and that have a cloud-based API integration, all three methods will be offered to you, so you can choose what method suits you best. I'm talking about Home Assistant all of the time. That is because it is a great smart home hub, and it is actually the best one available at the moment. However, there are four official methods to get Home Assistant, and I cover them all in my Home Assistant webinar. On top, I'm talking there about one secret way to start Home Assistant on your PC in under 5 minutes. If you're interested, go register right now on my website automatelike.pro/webinar. It is absolutely free. Thanks for watching. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!